busted with ganja, one found with cocaine. Murder gets 60 years, family decries the sentence. Tilapia rearing deemed feasible at Wales Estate. 3% of Guyanese has sickle cell. And in court, trial of Anil Nanlal begins, accused of stealing $2 million worth in law books. Those are the top headlines for Tuesday, June 20. Good evening, I'm Trish Ramlal with the news and details. Two intelligence-led operations on the east bank of Essequibo and New Amsterdam Barbies have resulted in the arrest of four males and the seizure of 4.5 kilograms of compressed cannabis and 31.3 grams of cocaine. On Monday, June 19, during a sting operation, ranks went to a house at Tugboro Park, New Amsterdam Barbies, where three men were arrested and taken into custody with 9 taped parcels of cannabis weighing 4.5 kilograms. Over at Perica Sidam, police conducted a search at a shop on Tuesday, June 20, and in the presence of the 47-year-old owner, the ranks found a quantity of cocaine pellets inside a hammock in which he was seen resting. They are being processed for court. More news still ahead, do stay tuned.
Everything is connected, our planet, our water sources, including the water we drink. Sometimes harmful bacteria end up in our streams and canals. Although treated, the risks are high. You can prevent this pollution and contamination by maintaining your septic tank and grease traps. Call the experts at Pooran Brothers Disposal Incorporated on 264-1239 or 603-5050. Keeping it clean is what we do best.
Do you have a business idea and don't know where to start?
Do you have a small business that has been stagnated and not growing? IPED can provide finance for as much as $20 million for you to acquire equipment, tools, machinery, and stocks to start or expand your business.
IPED can also provide mentoring and training for you to improve your business skills, marketing, and record keeping.
IPED, improving livelihoods.
Get going, keep growing with IPED.
Hey, you have a growing flesh there, and there too, and there is another one. Those ugly and annoying growing flesh, like a plague, ignoring them, and before you know, you have them everywhere. SlimJet presenting Coleomac, the most effective growing flesh and wart remover. Painlessly remove ugly growing flesh is the quick and effective way. Get soft, smooth, growing flesh-free skin, guarantee. Just apply Coleomac twice a day and the growing flesh just dry up and fall off. Easy, quick, and painless. Stop suffering and feeling embarrassed. Remove those ugly growing flesh with Coleomac. Only at SlimJet, City Mall, second floor, or in New Amsterdam, 22 Asylum and Main Road, Berbice.
One of the parties which constitute the coalition government is calling for the establishment of the Local Government Commission. That process began in late 2013 under the previous administration. However, the commission has not been established. Details in this report.
Executive member of the Working People's Alliance, Dr. David Hines, believes that the establishment of the Local Government Commission is long overdue. The WPE executive affirmed that even though there was local government elections in 2016, the commission is necessary.
We think that there should be much more reform in the local government system. One of the things that we have advocated in the past in UWPA is a return to the village councils, because we feel at that basic level in the community that people should be involved in making decisions.
Dr. Hines added that the local people should be more involved in decision-making at the level of the neighborhood democratic councils. He says the party has long advocated for reforms to be taken place before the commission can be established.
We feel that we've come somewhere in terms of local government reform, that we should go further than that. And certainly, we would like to see the local government commission be put in place.
In May 2016, Minister of Communities Ronald Bulkan had stated that the ministry is in the process of finalizing the names of the persons who would serve on the commission. Bulkan, during an interview with the Government Information Agency, said the process will wrap up soon and facilitate the operation of the commission by early June 2016. The minister's statement added that the ministry will now have time to focus on more strategic issues, including regions management. The Local Government Commission legislation came into being in late 2013, which required a commencement order for it to begin the process of selecting its members. Nikhil John, the reporting for MTV News Update.
Prime Minister Moses Nagamutu rebukes the efforts of opposition member Anil Nanla to allegedly incite sugar workers. This is in response to the opposition member's reminder that Nagamutu allegedly promised to pay the sugar workers an increase of 25% to their wages. Find out more in this report.
In a worded statement from the Office of the Prime Minister, it refutes alleged blatant falsehoods being peddled by opposition parliamentarian Anil Nanlal in a purported effort to incite sugar workers. The statement said Nanlal is reported to have stated that in 2011, the Prime Minister, then in opposition, had promised sugar workers 25% increase in wages. It added that this is a makeshift invention for which the opposition parliamentarian can give any proof. The statement further added that it is clear that Nanlal was allowed to run free against the Prime Minister after his devastating exposure of the Barjagli regime for purportedly bankrupting the sugar industry during the June 15 sitting of the National Assembly. The statement added that Nanlal is resorting to typical vendetta politics in a lame attempt at getting at the Prime Minister for Jagdeo's hopeless attempt to avoid blame for the crisis in the sugar industry. It said Nanlal is also peddling a huge lie that the coalition government had blocked bailouts for the sugar industry. On the contrary, the coalition government, even while it was in opposition, voted for every bailout package for sugar workers. Further, after taking office, the coalition government voted for over $32 billion from 2015 to 2017 to further help the sugar industry stay afloat and to pay wages to sugar workers, whilst it worked on a plan to make the industry profitable. The Office of the Prime Minister condemns Nanlal and the PPP for attempting to exploit the situation in the sugar industry by making it into a political fun game and for kicking the fate of sugar workers like a football. The statement cautioned sugar workers that they must not allow themselves to be fooled by political hustlers like opposition member Nanlal and must not fall victim to their desperate campaign of stirring racism and division. Nikhil John, the reporting for MTV News Update.
Commuters, including residents, tourists, miners, and business proprietors, can expect a vastly improved carriageway as the first phase of the long-awaited Linen-Letem Road project is expected to commence shortly. Permanent Secretary of the Ministry of Public Infrastructure, Jeffrey Vaughan, explained to the government's news agency that the Caribbean Development Bank and the government will advertise shortly for a consultant to review the existing studies for the works. Subsequently, tenders will be sent out for works to commence on the Linen-Letem Road. Coming up, WPA dissatisfied with government's approach to constitutional reform. And murderer gets 60 years, family decries sentence.
I am going to be strong.
I am going to do great. I'm going to be my best.
Good nutrition makes a difference. Lasco Food Drink gives you protein for muscle strength, calcium for bone strength, vitamins, minerals, and iron to keep you healthy.
Go!
Packed with nutrition, Lasco Food Drink. Make your day.
Distributed by Ansa Macau Trading Limited.
Modern Optical Service has made it even better by introducing its budgeted spectacle line, starting as low as $10,000 for single vision lens and $12,000 for bifocal lens, available in tinted or clear, complete spectacles at affordable prices. So hurry down to our main office at 316 Middle Street or Lot 14 Diamond Public Road opposite Demerara Bank. Enjoy over 60 years of eye care experience at affordable prices. Modern Optical Service, your eye care professionals.
Check us out at HomeSense Wholesale and Retail, 31 Traque Farm, East Bank, Demerara, for your household items such as carpets, mats, vases, stand fans, kitchen utensils, etc. We have in stock office chairs, plastic chairs, tents, outdoor patio sets, trampoline, children's swings, and much more. Also remember to check out our second branch at 93 Grove Public Road. Visit us today for the best deals and amazing prices on adults and children footwear, undergarments, children book bags, lunch bags, bicycles, beach chairs and accessories, baby care items, and a whole lot more. So the next time you're thinking about going shopping, remember to visit HomeSense Wholesale and Retail. Telephone numbers 638-6861 or 619-8502.
You can be a millionaire by only spending $100 on a Daily Million ticket. Simply pick any five numbers from 1 to 26, or you can buy a quick pick for your chance to win the Daily Millions. Purchase your tickets daily, Monday through Saturday, to get a chance to win $1 million every day. So, feeling lucky? Then buy a Daily Millions ticket today. Remember, a ticket today could make you rich today.
Continues on MTV. The Working People's Alliance is not satisfied with the action of the coalition government on the issue of the constitutional reform. The party believes that in its history of contributing to the manifesto of the coalition government, it has always fought for reforms. Nicol Joandu filed this report.
In every manifesto, if you go back to 1985, right through to the present, every manifesto that the WP has been involved in, constitutional reform has been part of it. And we fought for the inclusion of constitutional reform as a very important and central plank of this manifesto.
That was executive member of the Working People's Alliance, Dr. David Hines. Dr. Hines says the WPA is not satisfied that the government is moving purposefully in addressing constitutional reform. The executive member added that the Hughes Commission submitted its report to Prime Minister Moses Nagamutu since last year. Dr. Hines further added that ever since Prime Minister Nagamutu spoke on the matter, he is only dragging his feet.
We are dissatisfied with that. We feel that constitutional reform is critical to everything that we are doing, because constitutional reform has to do with the way the state, for example, is reconstructed. Constitutional reform has to do with allocation of power. Constitutional reform has to do with the whole question of ethnicity.
The WPA executive member believes that the powers which the president has should be reduced, which comes back to the very critical question of when will constitutional reform begin.
We feel that despite some modification the last time around, in 1999-2001, that the presidential powers are still too much. And we would like to see a modification of those powers. So there are things that we feel that need to be done immediately, and that constitutional reform should be put on the table as a central plank. Ultimately, governments come and governments go.
The Carter Center, in its final report of the 2015 general and regional elections, noted that constitutional reform was key to address the winner-take-all system, and it does not serve the country's interest given the entrenched ethnic voting. The center welcomed the APNU plus AFC commitment to mount fundamental constitutional reform to achieve more inclusive governance and power sharing, and urges the coalition to live up to its promise. Nikhil Jondo reporting for MTV News Update.
The Ghana Revenue Authority will be implementing a more modern and customized solution to aid an effective customs administration. The software solution will eliminate the need for the manual retrieval of documents across agencies and will be completed and implemented by January 2018. It is an automated system for managing customs data, which aids in the efficiency of tax processing, prevention and detection of fraud, expedition of the clearance of goods, among others. Minister of State Joseph Harman announced the sum of $4.5 million will be invested to roll out this project. The contract was awarded to the United Nations Conference on Trade and Development. An Albois Tongue man will be spending the next 6 years of his life behind bars. He has been slapped with a thunderous sentence after being found guilty of murder. Find out more in this report.
Steve Alicock was sentenced to 60 years in prison for the death of Wendell Tappin in 2009. Alicock stood before a 12-member jury, which convicted him for the murder of Tappin. When the verdict was passed down by Justice Navendra Singh, Alicock's father became vocal. The man argued that his son was wrongfully accused of the murder, even though evidence suggests that Alicock was not present at the crime scene, the father lamented.
In his testimony with me, he said a Negro man come up, take away the knives from everyone and the person who they run in his son. His son didn't get joked, give it to me. I collect the knives, right? His son still standing up there. His son didn't run away. His son standing up because his son is stormed. He said, well, here I stand up here for y'all kill me today. After the man gave me the knives, I take the knives now and distribute it back to me children. Them and tell me children kill him. That's what he said.
The stabbing took place in Albois Tongue when Tappin was involved in an argument with another man. It was reported in the media that the alleged attacker stabbed Tappin in his chest and escaped. Tappin was allegedly stabbed over a cellular phone battery. The deceased mother, during an interview, says justice has been served.
I feel that justice has to be here. I guess then and he had a son, and then his wife was pregnant, and that child don't know his father. But he's very brilliant in school, and he's doing very well. Two of them, they are doing very well.
Alicock's father and uncle were also charged for the murder. However, they were found not guilty and subsequently freed of the charge. Nikhil Jondo reporting for MTV News Update.
Shocking stats released by the Georgetown Public Hospital Corporation reveals that 3% of Guyanese are living with anemia, also known as sickle cell. They are being asked to seek medical attention with urgency.
Fighting against sickle cell stigma faces is edifying and sensitizing the public about anemia in an effort to ensure sicklers are treated without bias and provided quality health care. Founder of FACES, Sabrina Kasim, advocates for a partnership to be developed to ensure a better quality life for sicklers. Pediatrician at the Georgetown Public Hospital Corporation, Dr. Sherlyn Staton, says those aware of the disease should seek medical attention with urgency. Migrations and interracial marriages have been cited as a main spread of sickle cell, as persons of African descent were the ones known to contain the disease. 3,000 babies are born annually in low and middle income countries with the disease, according to Staton.
Whether you're a carrier or you're aware that you have a family member or a child who has sickle cell or thalassemia, that they enroll in a clinic that can actually monitor their disease and ensure that they can have a healthy life.
According to Dr. Staton, 3% of Guyanese have been found to be carriers of the sickle cell. Additionally, some 106 persons were showing signs of the disease.
Now, persons who have sickle cell disease have many symptoms of the disease, but not everybody experiences the very same symptoms. So, persons who have this very same genes may have severe to not so severe or mild symptoms.
Sickle cell disease is a group of disorders that are affected with hemoglobin, the molecule of red blood cells that delivers oxygen throughout the body. Sandy Ramutar for MTV's News Update.
More news still ahead, stay with us.
Nothing compares to the class and beauty of Beeson Windows and Doors. Engineered by professionals and built to last longer than the competition. Buy 10 windows and get one 24x16 bathroom window absolutely free. No tricks, no gimmicks, and no hidden fees. Prices starting from 13.5 VAT inclusive. So visit our showroom today at Lot 1228 New Eccles Industrial Site or BPAT's building on Regent Street and save big on UPVC or aluminum windows. To order now, call 622-4197 or 226-1292.
Yes is a beautiful word. It empowers us. It brings satisfaction. And since you earn up to 3% cash back on everyday purchases with the Scotiabank Gold MasterCard, that's a lot of satisfaction. A lot more often. Plus, you get a welcome bonus. Scotiabank Gold MasterCard is the card that keeps on giving, so it's easier for you to create many more precious yes moments. Apply for yours today. Call or visit a Scotiabank branch to find out more.
Sino Mall has new arrivals for you. From chic female tops to casual tops, trendy rompers, hot short pants, mini skirts, exotic lingerie, curvy jeans and leggings, nightgowns, sizzling swimwear, a world of panties to make you feel and look good. Just arrived are comfortable bras for all sizes, stylish strap bags, clutch-style purses that makes a fashion statement. And for the kids, their cartoon towels and a wide range of costume jewelry for that final touch. Come into Sino Mall today at 16 Cole Street, Georgetown, opposite Demico and the Kitty Bus Park. Call 231-8200 or 617-60...
Welcome back. Persons who feel that their eyes are infected are being urged to visit the nearest health center in the community as soon as possible. In the last week alone, the Campbellfield Health Center has seen 179 cases of conjunctivitis, better known as red eye. Conditions of red eye include a sandy feeling in the eyes, itching or burning, excessive tearing, discharge from one or both eyes, swollen eyelids, pink discoloration of the eyes, and increased sensitivity to light. Persons are advised to avoid touching eyes with your hands, wash hands frequently with soap and water, use antibacterial hand sanitizer, avoid sharing towels, blankets, and pillowcases to prevent the spread of conjunctivitis. The report on the feasibility study for aquaculture as a diversification venture for Gaisuku has significant potential. This is according to the Guyana Sugar Company.
The Guyana Sugar Corporation prepares to look at a new horizon as the sugar production is becoming more unfeasible. It is due to this long-known fact that the coalition government had initiated a feasibility study for aquaculture as a diversification venture for Gaisuku. The study was undertaken by Aquasol Corporation, Inc., a company that is based in Florida, United States of America. The study, according to the sugar company, concludes that aquaculture has a significant potential as a diversification mechanism. The study highlighted that Guyana's climatic conditions and soil types are ideal to support high growth rates for tilapia throughout the year. While the main products considered in the report were tilapia and shrimp, the report concluded that tilapia was more suited for the Whales Estate project site than shrimp that requires a relatively saline environment. On the operational side, the study proposes that a capacity of the corporation will have to be built from an organizational perspective, systems and retraining of employees, as well as recruiting appropriate skills and expertise for technical and operational management. Market opportunities for this venture are to a small extent local and regional. However, the main target market would be the United States of America. Godfrey Brooms, MTV News Update.
As the Guyana Teachers Union continues to champion teachers' rights, they were able to overthrow a policy against teachers by the Region 5's regional executive officer.
This follows a meeting with the Ministries of Education and Communities officials, along with the regional executive officer and union representatives. Secretary of the Guyana Teachers Union, Coretta MacDonald, says the meeting bore fruit as the RU attached to the Region 5 Council was unable to provide any authoritative documents. The regional executive officer claimed the new policy came into effect in April. The policy, according to him, states that teachers' salaries should be withheld in lieu of notice requesting leave. The RU has stated the decision came following teachers abandoning their duties and in some cases overstaying their vacation. On the other hand, it was agreed that those salaries will be released for the months of June, July and August. However, those teachers are expected to resume duties in September of this year. Teachers picketed a council on June 12 and 13, calling for their salaries to be released, claiming it has been withheld for about 3 months. Sandy Ramutar for MTV's News Update.
The Child Care and Protection Agency of the Ministry of Social Protection, along with the Ministry of Education and the Guyana Responsible Parenthood Association, are currently conducting a joint outreach program in Region 9. The outreach seeks to raise awareness on issues surrounding children and their safety. The awareness session also involves talks on STIs, cancers related to sexual activities, and the importance of not being involved to early sexual activities. This awareness campaign is also being conducted in order to develop community watch groups within Region 9. In this way, persons in the different communities can act as frontline officers to have sexual child abuse cases reported. As Guyanese gets ready for the Caribbean Premier League, telephone giant Guyana Telephone and Telegraph Company inked an agreement which branded the firm as the official sponsor of the Guyana Amazon Warriors.
Speaking at the launch, Chief Executive Officer of GTT, Justin Ned, pledged to bring more services to the table. He says the company is on a mission to reach out and touch the hearts of every Guyanese through the partnership.
So today I can proudly say that GTT is the signature sponsor of the Amazon Warriors. It's not just about cricket, it's about the people of Guyana.
Ned says the launch reawakened much expectation, hype and excitement which will be experienced by the Caribbean throughout the local leg of the matches.
At GTT, we'll be bringing the heat, the passion and the positive vibes to cricket and the Guyana Amazon Warriors. We promise nothing short of excitement for CPL in Guyana 2017.
The company also unveiled the Amazon Warriors theme song, which is a musical rendition between two local music stars, Calvin Brunette and Drew Tovin. In August, four matches are expected to be played at the Guyana National Stadium. Also present at the launch was Director of Sports Christopher Jones, who gave the government commitment to develop sports. Brimming with optimism, Jones says people are expecting nothing less but victory for the Guyana Amazon Warriors. Sandy Ramutar for MTV's News Update.
Stay tuned for regional and international news, court roundup, as well as the Guyana Stock Exchange.
For over 64 years, Gafoors has been your number one hardware supplier. And today, we're the largest manufacturer of PVC and plastic products in Guyana. We produce pipes Schedule 40, DWV, SDR 21 and SDR 26 in sizes half inch to 12 inches, electrical conduits, PVC gutters in 9 foot 6 inches and 16 foot lengths, water tanks sizes from 200 gallons to 1600 gallons, stackable water tanks for easy transportation, size 450 gallons, pipes and gutter fittings, which include elbows, adapters, tees, straps and brackets, and buckets, bottles and containers with covers in various sizes. Our PVC and plastic products are available at any of our several locations and at many hardware stores countrywide. Gafoors, the name you can trust. Thinking of a career as an aviation engineer? Enroll in the Art Williams and Harry Ment Aeronautical Engineering School 2018 class and watch your career take off. Find out what we've got to offer at our Open Career Day on Friday, July 7, 2017 at the CAMS Hangar, Eugene F. Carey International Airport. For more information, call 222-2155 or 222-7045 or visit our website, www.aesguyana.net. The Art Williams and Harry Ment Aeronautical Engineering School, where the sky is the limit.
What went down at the Georgetown Magistrates' Courts on Tuesday, June 20.
Special Organized Crime Unit Prosecutor Patrice Henry called the two witnesses to testify this morning when the trial of former Attorney General Anil Nandlal, who was accused of stealing $2 million in Commonwealth law reports from the state, commenced before Magistrate Fabio Azor. One of the witnesses was Daniel Persaud, an accounts clerk at the Ministry of Legal Affairs. Persaud, who told the court that he also performed the duties as stores clerk, said that the only reports he is aware of are those he received after Nandlal demitted office as Attorney General in 2015. Persaud recalled that on June 2, 2015, he received a call from the Permanent Secretary of the Legal Affairs Ministry to go to her office. He added that he visited the Permanent Secretary's office with the immediate use book. According to the witness, the Permanent Secretary had the Commonwealth law reports in her possession and he made entries of them in the immediate use book with a description of the items, amount, and the serial number. Persaud recounted taking the law reports to the library at the Ministry of Legal Affairs and handing them over to Lana Best, the librarian who signed for them. Also testifying was Ms. Joe, a former stores clerk at the Ministry of Legal Affairs. She held that position for 15 years and has since gone into retirement. Nandlal is contending that the year when he took up office as Attorney General, he did so at a loss, and it was for that reason he made a deal for the state to pay for the law reports. He revealed that the agreement received the blessing of the then President, Donald Ramatar. However, the Ministry of Legal Affairs is contending that there is no evidence of the agreement between Nandlal and the former president. The trial continues on July 13. The trial of convicted drug trafficker Dennis Albert Jones, who is back in court again for allegedly trafficking 10.618 kilograms of cocaine at the Guyana Post Office Corporation, continued this morning before Chief Magistrate Anne McLennan. The court is presently conducting a voir dire to determine the admissibility of an alleged caution statement given to Customs Anti-Narcotic Unit Officer Joseph Innes by Jones. KANU Officer Agri Reynolds, who witnessed the taking of the alleged caution statement, was called to testify by Konyo Sandiford, KANU prosecutor. The witness gave evidence in relation to him being present when the statement was taken by KANU Officer Innes from Jones. According to reports, KANU Ranks intercepted a box on January 20 at the Guyana Post Office Corporation. The box, which contained Banco wine bottles and baking powder sachets, was being sent to Toronto, Canada by Jones. The cocaine was found concealed in the Banco wine bottles and baking sachets. Jones is currently on trial before another magistrate for allegedly forging a national identification card. Based on reports, Jones, of Caneview Avenue South, Rumville to Georgetown, was jailed for 4 years in 2012 for trafficking cocaine in soap powder. Godfrey Brooms, MTV News Update.
The Ghana Stock Exchange closing prices for trading session 7:26. Let's turn our attention to the Demerara Harbor Bridge schedule. That sums up our newscast for the night, but before we go, here's a recap of our major headlines. Three busted with ganja, one found with cocaine. Murderer gets 60 years, family decries the sentence. Tilapia rearing deemed feasible at Wales Estate. 3% of Guyanese has sickle cell. And in court, trial of Anil Nandlal begins, accused of stealing $2 million worth in law books. The newscast can be viewed online on MTV's Facebook page and also on our YouTube channel. The news will be rebroadcasted later tonight at 23 hours and at 6 hours 30 on Wednesday, June 21. On behalf of our news team, I am Trisha Ramlal, thanking you for watching. Remember, suicide is never the answer, as problem comes and goes.